In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use basic shortcuts. I won't be covering all available shortcuts in Blender, because we won't be using them all the time. I'll post a link to Blender's official keymap page that lists mostly used shortcuts. Let's go to Edit and Preferences. I'll show you how to change Blender's theme and add new add-ons. Let's go to Themes. There are multiple themes available, but they're hidden from the view. That's how we change the themes in Blender. Let's go to Add-ons, and look for Extra. Please put check marks on both add-ons, as they'll add extra curve and mesh objects to Blender. Let's add an add-on called Node Wrangler. Node Wrangler is used to save time when we're working with the nodes while applying the materials. Lastly, we need Loop Tools. Loop Tools is a great tool used to save time while modifying the meshes. Click the middle mouse button and drag to orbit the viewport. Mouse wheel up or down will zoom in or out. If your mouse doesn't have the middle mouse button, then use numpad plus or numpad minus. If you don't have the numpad on your keyboard, then go to Edit, Preferences and Input to activate Emulate 3-button mouse. After that, use the plus or the minus keys to zoom in or out. I would highly recommend everyone using Blender to use the 3-button mouse and a keyboard with the numpad keys. Click and hold the middle mouse button while pressing the Shift key to pan the view. For those who don't have the numpad keys, we can use the backquote key located above the tab key to manually switch the viewports. Numpad 0 will show what the camera sees, and that's what's going to appear in the final render image. To set a new camera angle, we can press Alt, Control, and Numpad 0 together. If you don't have the numpad, please manually move and rotate the camera to set the render view. The set of icons category on the left side is known as the toolbar. We can use the gizmos like this, and make changes visually. Red means X, green means Y, and blue means Z. We can limit the movement, rotate, or scale by clicking and dragging them. On the opposite side of the toolbar, we have the properties bar. Pressing T will show or hide the toolbar, and pressing N will show or hide the properties bar. Pressing Ctrl and Space together will remove most of the bars. Ctrl, Alt, and Space together will only show the object in the window. Ctrl, Alt, and Q together will show the quad view. Left-click the mesh to select, and H to hide. Alt and H together to unhide. Shift D to duplicate. There's another duplication method, and that's Alt H. Select while holding Shift to select multiple objects at the same time. G to move, R to rotate, and S to scale. We can group objects by selecting them first and pressing Ctrl and J together. To remove an object from the group, Tab to go to edit mode, hover the mouse cursor over an object, and type P to separate by selection. We can even separate any parts of a mesh by using the P key like this. X to delete, and Ctrl Z to undo. Shift, Ctrl, and Z together to redo. Without using the Move Gizmo's RGB handles, we can type G and X to move the object only on the X axis. G and Y to move on the Y axis. G and Z to move on the Z axis.